When you're going through a tough time, what do? Most of us lean on friends and family. And that is what the president is doing right now, embracing Fox, promoting the network even more than usual. He's urging people to tune in, and he's finding solace in the spin. Notably, he did start the week by complaining about Fox's town hall with Bernie Sanders. "What are we doing?" he asked. But his sniping at the news division is outweighed by his support for the opinion side. When the attorney general was about to hold his presser on Thursday afternoon, Trump wanted people to watch on his pre-approved channels. He listed two of them there. At the end of the day, he even tweeted out a promo of Fox's primetime lineup, but then deleted it for some reason. Shameless plugging doesn't even begin to describe it. The president knows he has a friend in Fox. So before all this, before the Mueller report hit, a left-leaning website called Now This came out with a video that you have to see.
What is wrong with this president? How dumb is he?
The purpose of a journalist is to hold people in power accountable.
Now, we're going to vet the president. We're going to talk about his vacation, his golfing.
Two golf outings for the president cost $2.9 million. That alone is amazing.
Should a president, the leader of the free world, be on a social network tweeting?
No.
He's kind of a celebrity president. He's kind of like Ryan Seacrest.
This is a president who does not really know what he wants to do. He simply wants to be popular with everybody, every audience before which he stands.
The president seems almost obsessed with cable TV, or am I wrong?
Jay, to you first. You recently wrote that the president and his supporters exist in an information loop where all they learn about Trump is from Trump. How do you diagnose this? What is it? What's going on?
Well, it's as if one third of the public has been broken off from the rest of the electorate and isolated in an information system of its own.
Do you think it's that bad? It's that stark?
I do. And I think it's not only that they are inclined to trust the president more than the news system. It's that the White House and Trump himself is trying to eviscerate the whole idea of a public record or of an independent source of facts on which the country can disagree and argue about. And I think that goes way beyond the notion of bias in the media or look skeptically at what you are told. It's actually an authoritarian news system that is up and running in the country that is known for having the freest press in the world. And I think this is extraordinary. And we don't always have the language we need to talk about it.